Hello everybody, today we are going to see next congruency criteria, that is ASA congruency. Okay, already we have seen SAS, side angle side. Okay, depend on this proof, depend on that criteria we are going to prove for ASA. Okay, so see here, what is given? Condition 2, angle side angle congruence criteria. Okay, so this we are going to prove. Now here statement is given, see, two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of the other triangle. Okay, so that is given, the statement is given. According to this, we are going to think about this first bit. Okay, so I will explain about this also. Now see here, this is we are going to relate with the given statement. So what is given? See, two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle. Included side. Suppose here we will say angle B is equals to angle E, angle C is equals to angle F, and BC is equals to EF. Why BC only? Because they have told us here included side of angles, by the angle. See, BC is included by angle B and angle C. Okay, as well as EF is included, side EF is included by angle E and angle F. So included side is important. Here we cannot take side AC or side BF or this side BE. Okay, two angles and included side we need to. Okay, so now see here, according to this, first we will write given things. What is given? Given triangles are given, triangle ABC and triangle DEF. These two triangles are given. Okay, now what is given? Two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of the other triangle. Okay, we see here what is given. Base angles are given. Angle B is equals to angle E, that is given. One more angle is given, angle C is equals to angle F. Angle C is equals to angle F. And included side is BC is equals to EF. Okay, so these things are given from the triangle. You can see here in the figure. Okay, now we have to prove. What we have to prove? Two triangles are congruent. We have to prove that both the triangles are congruent. So that is to prove. Triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. Triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent, that we have proved. Okay. So now in the proof there are three steps, three cases are there. Okay. So according to this, this is we will see first case number one. That is when AB is equals to DE. Okay. This AB side and DE side is equal, because here we are going to use SAS criteria. Okay, with the help of side angle side, with the help of this criteria we are going to use. So we must have two sides and one angle. Here what is given? Two angles and one side is given, but we are going to use SAS criteria. So we must have two sides and one angle, one included angle. Okay, so here what we will think first, here AB is equals to DE, we will assume that. Supposition we are doing, AB is equals to DE. Okay. In second case, what we will do? Case number 2. Case second, what we will do when AB is shorter than or smaller than DE? DE. Okay. When AB is smaller than DE. And in third case, what we will do? When AB, case number 3, when AB is greater than DE. AB is greater than DE. Okay, so this and this is important. The proof for the case third will be as same as this. Okay, so see carefully. Now see, why we are doing supposition for everybody? Because we are going to use side angle side property. So we need two sides and one angle. So this side is given, angle is given, but one more side will be. So we are considering here AB is equals to DE. Okay, but we are considering it is, so we cannot take final limits. So maybe AB is shorter than DE or AB may be larger than DE also. So all the three things we are checking. Okay. So case number one, AB is equals to DE. When AB and DE are equal, that time very easy. We can do proof in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, AB is equals to DE. Okay. Why? According to the supposition we have considered that supposition. Okay. Then angle ABC, angle ABC is equals to angle DEF. DEF. Why? Because it is given. And last one, BC is equals to EF. BC is equals to EF. So that is also given. Okay. So we can say triangle ABC formulated triangle DEF. Triangle ABC formulated DEF. Okay. Triangle ABC and DEF are congruent by which criteria? Side angle side. This is side, this is angle, and this is side. By SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. So here they have given us two angles and one included side. Okay. Is equal to the corresponding two angles and included side. Okay. So the same triangles, same pair of triangles we have given to with the help of SAS criteria. Okay. Now here we have considered AB and DE are equal, but maybe AB is shorter than DE. So in that condition, what is happening that we are going to see. Okay. So here what is given, case number 2, AB is smaller than DE. AB is smaller than DE. Means definitely this DE is greater than AB. Okay. So this, I am shifting this D point. See carefully. Okay, so the D point was here, now it is shifted, and that suppose D point is here. Okay, so now in this condition DE is greater than AB. DE is greater than AB, or AB is shorter than DE also we can say. Okay, now D point was here, but it is shifted now here. So I am giving here name G. Okay, now I am joining this D and F. Okay, now what is happening that we are going to see. Okay, is it getting result same or any different result, that also we need to see. Okay, so now see here what is given. Now AB is equals to GE. Getting everybody? AB is equals to GE according to the supposition we have taken here. AB and DE are equal. Okay, but from this point D is shifted here. So D is shifted, but this GE and AB will be same. Okay, according to the supposition. So that I am taking now in triangle ABC and triangle GEF. Triangle GEF. What we can say? AB is equals to GE by supposition. Okay. Now what is angle ABC is equals to angle GEF. Why? Given. This is given. Okay, that is given. This angle and angle E are equal. That is given. Now BC, this and this is given. So we can say BC is equals to EF. BC is equals to EF. That is also given. So now we can say triangle ABC congruent triangle GEF by SAS, side angle set, by side angle set. Okay, criteria, these two triangles are equal. Okay, but actually our triangle is DEF. Okay, so we need to think about triangle ABC and triangle DEF. Okay, so we are going to think about that also. Okay, so what is saying? Triangle ABC and GEF are equal. Okay, so can I say here angle ACB and GFE are equal? Angle ACB is equals to angle GFE. Okay, why? What is the reason behind this? CPCP, corresponding parts of congruent. Okay, so I can see here everybody, this angle, both the triangles are congruent, ABC and GEF. So this angle and this angle is equal. Okay, but what is given here? they have told us angle C and angle F is equal. Angle C and angle F, this angle and this whole angle is DFE. What is given? DFE, angle ACB, but angle ACB is equals to angle DFE. DFE, they have told us. DFE, this is given. It means what? It means what? ACB is equals to DFE and ACB is equals to GFE. So can I say here angle GFE is equals to angle DFE from this and this? Can we say angle GFE? GFE means this angle. GFE is equals to this angle and DFE is this angle are equal according to this. But when it is possible? When it is possible? When G and D are coincides. G and D are the same point, coincide points. Or we can say GF and DF are coincide. Okay? So here we need to write reason. It is possible when G and D are coincide points. Coincide points. Or GF, or we can say GF and DF are coincides. Okay, coincide. That time only it is possible. Otherwise, this here by looking you will get different angles. Angles are different. We can understand from figure. Okay, but GF and DF are equal means when these line segments or sides are equal and G and D points are coincides. That time this is possible. This is possible. Okay, so what we can say finally? AB, here also we can say AB is equals to DE. AB is equals to this. Both the points are same only. Both the points are same. So AB is equals to DE. Then angle B is equals to angle E. And last BC is equals to EF. Okay. So here we can say triangle ABC, congruent triangle DEF by SAS. My SAS method. Okay, got it everybody? Now this was the second condition. Now third condition, we are thinking about third condition. Third condition, explanation will come same. Only I am going to do explanation in the figure. Okay, so what is the third condition? When AB is greater than DE. When AB is greater than DE. Okay. When AB is greater than D, is definitely this DE is shorter than AB, is this D point will shift here somewhere downside. Okay, then only it will be DE is shorter. So D will come here, this point DE is shifted here, so here I am taking G. Here I am taking G. Understood? So now this D point I will join here with F. Okay, so this is point D, this is point D. And now we are going to think about DEF and ABC. DEF and ABC. What did everybody? Condition was given AB is greater than DE. AB is greater than DE. Okay, so the D point we have taken downside. D point we have taken downside. Then only DE will get shorter than AB. So this point is there, so that point we have given name G. Okay, so now here also we need to write what we can write here. AB is equals to GE. The same explanation is going to come. AB is equals to GE. B, angle B is equals to angle E. BC is equals to EF. BC is equals to EF. That is given. Angle E is equals to angle B. That is also given. And AB is equals to GE. AB is equals to GE. Okay. By supposition, so triangle ABC and GEF are congruent by SAS criteria. Then second, after that what we will do? We can say ACB and DFE are equal by CPCB. But what is given? DFE D F E and A C B is given. The same it will come. G F E. Yes, see. A C B and G F E. After that, A C B and D F E. It is given. That this is given. So according to that, G F E is equal to D F E. So it is possible when it is possible when D and G are coincidences. That time only it is possible. Or D F and G F are coincidences. Understood? So this explanation only you have to write. You can take reference from the NCERT book. Okay, theorem is given in that book. So you can see once again if you want. So see here once again I am explaining the same theorem. See carefully. What was given? Two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of the other triangle. So what is given here? Triangle ABC and triangle DEF was given. Then you will ask why three conditions we have taken. Why three conditions we have taken? Because we are going to give here proof with the help of SAS criteria, which we have learned. Understood? See, we don't know other criteria, so we cannot use those criteria. So here we have taken the reference of SAS criteria. So we must have two sides and one included angle. For that, we have taken AB is equals to DE. But here we cannot say permanently AB or AB and DE are same. Maybe AB is shorter than DE or AB is greater than DE. So accordingly we have taken two different conditions. Understood? So now here when AB and DE are equal, that time by SAS criteria we can prove easily. When AB is shorter than DE, that time what we have done? We have taken shifted this D point outside. That time this DE is greater than AB according to the given condition. Okay, so that time also we can give proof, but we can show here ABC and GEF are congruent. But what is given here ACB, here we got according to this ACB and GFE are equal by CPCT and according to the proof, but it is given that ACB and DFE are congruent. This definitely this angle and this angle is equal, but when it is possible, when G and D point will come together, that time only it is possible. Or GF and DF will coincide, that time only it is possible. Okay, so again we have given proof by SAS criterion, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, the same thing when in case that when AB is greater than DE, AB is greater than DE. So this D point was here, that is shifted it down, that side we made shorter than the AB. Okay, but the explanation will come same. Okay, thank you. In figure, diagonal AC of quadrilateral ABCD, diagonal AC of quadrilateral ABCD bisects the angle A and C. Prove that AB is equal to AD and CB is equal to CD. Prove that AB is equal to AD and CB is equal to CD. Means we have to prove AB and AD are equal, as well as CD and CB are equal. Okay. So if you observe this, due to this bisector, due to bisector AC, the quadrilateral is divided into two triangles. Okay, but this is bisect the angle A and C. Bisect the angle A and C means definitely this angle and this angle will be equal. These two angles are equal. Okay, as well as it bisects angle C also. So this angle BCA is equals to angle DCA. Okay. So if I want to prove that AB and AD and CB and CD are equal of both the triangles, so first I need to prove that both the triangles are congruent. Once I will give proof both the triangles are congruent, then we can say by CPCT this remaining sides or remaining angles, whatever they are asking, they are equal. Okay, so first what is required, we need to prove that both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so here we can say in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC and triangle ADC, in triangle ADC, what is given? These are the bisectors. So what we can say? BAC angle BAC is equals to angle BAC is equals to BAC angle BAC. Okay, why? AC is bisector, that is given, of angle A. This is bisector of angle A. Then what we can say? AC is equals to AC. We are thinking about these two triangles. AC is equals to AC. That is common side. AC is equals to AC. That is common. Okay. And next, BCA is equals to DCA. Angle BCA is equals to BCA is equals to angle DCA. This is here also AC is bisector of angle A of angle C. Okay, AC is the bisector of angle C. It divides two equal into two equal angles. Okay, so here we can see here we got here first one is BAC. This is angle. Second one is side and third one is angle. So we can see triangle ABC congruent triangle ABC by which criterion? Angle side angle. So ASP by ASP. Okay, both the triangles are congruent. Now if triangles are congruent, we can say AB, whatever they are asking, AB is equal to AD and CB is equal to CD. Why? By CPC, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, so whenever other things they are asking, that time we need to show that both the triangles are congruent. Okay. Okay, see here our next problem is AB is a line segment. We have given figure. AB is a line segment. AX and BY are two equal line segments. AX and BY are two equal line segments. Drawn on opposite sides of line AB. Drawn on opposite sides of line AB. Okay, such that AX is parallel to BY. AX is parallel to BY. Means this AX and BY is parallel. Okay. Now, if AB and XY intersect each other at point P, AB and XY intersect at point P. Prove that triangle APX congruent triangle BPY, triangle APX this and BPY this, both the triangles are congruent. And AP and XY bisect each other. AP and XY bisect each other. Okay, AB, AB and XY bisect each other. Okay. So now see here, two triangles are given and one thing they have told us, that is AX is parallel to BY. AX is parallel to BY. Okay, so we can mention in the given things. What is given? Given AB is AB AX is equals to AX is parallel to BY. AX is parallel to BY. This is one thing. This one thing is given. Also, they have told us AX is equals to BY. AX and BY are equal. This and this is equal. Okay, so one thing we have now. Now, second thing, are two equal line segments drawn on opposite sides of line AB such that AX is parallel to BY. If AB and XY intersect each other at point B, prove that APX and what we have to prove? Which are given things. Triangle APX congruent triangle BPY and second thing, this is first and second is AB and XY bisect each other. Okay, so here this is important. When you will prove triangles are congruent, both the triangles are congruent, that time automatically second answer you will get. Okay, so here first we will think about first question, that is triangle APX and second BPY are congruent. Okay, one thing they have told us, AX and BY are parallel. AX and BY are parallel. Okay, so see here carefully, when AX and BY are parallel, that time AB will work as a transversal. AB will work as a transversal. So definitely angle A and angle B are equal because lines are parallel it cut by a transversal. Two lines are parallel, cut by a transversal. That time alternate interior angles are equal. So angle A and angle B are equal. What did you repeat? Second thing, these two lines are parallel. That time XY is also working as a transversal. XY is also working as a transversal. So here also we can say angle X and angle Y are equal. Finish. So here angle, side, angle. Okay, angle, side, angle. By that criteria we can show both the triangles are congruent. Once we will give proof for this, then we can say AP is equals to PB and XP is equals to YP because CP is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, so whenever you will solve this, when you will start to solve such type of theorems or examples, that time you must have first the direction. We have to decide what actually we need to do and then bring on the paper. Okay, so here I am taking here a triangle AXP and triangle BPY. What I can see here?